Welcome to the Chapter 22 lecture on GDP and CPI, Tracking the Macroeconomy. We are going to start working with statistics to measure the size of economies and track growth over time. The math in this chapter is not complicated, but it is important that you use the correct formulas when calculating each statistic. The way to measure a nation's income is by calculating GDP. GDP stands for Gross Domestic Product. GDP is the measure of the total income of a nation. This is one of the most closely watched economic statistics because it tells us whether or not we are in a recession. But we'll get to that in coming chapters. GDP is the single best measure of economic well-being that we have. This does not mean that GDP is a perfect statistic. We'll discuss some of the problems with GDP at the end of this chapter. GDP measures two things at once: total income of everyone in the economy and total expenditure on the economy's output of goods and services. GDP can measure two things at once because income and expenditures are essentially the same. Think through the logic. Every transaction has a buyer and seller. Every dollar of spending by some buyer is a dollar of income for some seller. The money continuously flows from the buyers to the sellers, then back to the buyers, just like how the money flowed in the circular flow diagram. GDP is just measuring the flow of money. In one direction, it is total income, and in the other direction, it is total expenditure. The words expenditure and spending mean the same thing. GDP can be divided into four components. We are going to use the variable Y for GDP. When we start working on the math, it will be easier to have a single letter variable for gross domestic product rather than a three-letter variable. GDP is divided into consumption, C, investment, I, government purchases, G, and net exports, NX. Consumption plus investment plus government purchases plus net exports equals GDP. This equation is an identity, meaning it must hold true the way the variables are defined. There are two different ways to calculate GDP: real GDP and nominal GDP. Remember, GDP measures total spending. If total spending increases, one of two things must be true. The economy is producing more goods and services, or goods and services are being sold at higher prices. We want to separate these two effects. Therefore, we calculate nominal GDP, which includes both effects, and real GDP, which focuses on the quantity being produced. Real GDP is the total quantity of goods and services the economy is producing that is not affected by changes in the price of those goods and services. Real GDP shows how overall production changes over time because it is a measure of quantity. Real GDP is calculated with constant prices. Nominal GDP is calculated with current prices. Since prices stay constant with real GDP, it only reflects change in the amount of goods and services being produced, since quantity is the only variable changing. The goal of GDP is to gauge how well the economy is doing. Economists prefer real GDP over nominal GDP because it is a better gauge of economic well-being, since it reflects the economy's ability to satisfy people's wants and needs. We finished the chapter with a quick discussion about how good of a measure GDP is to gauge economic well-being. The answer is GDP is not a perfect measure. GDP emits the value of goods and services produced at home. Only goods and services produced and sold in legal markets are counted towards GDP, so anything produced at home does not get accounted for. GDP excludes the quality of the environment, education, and healthcare. When we talk about the well-being of a country, the quality of the environment, the availability of education, and access to healthcare should be considered. However, GDP does not tell us anything about the quality of those factors. GDP says nothing about distribution of income. Calculating GDP does not tell us the size of the middle class, or how income is divided between the upper, middle, and lower classes. Lastly, GDP misses many transactions that occur in the underground economy. The underground economy is everything from illegal drugs to lemonade stands. If a transaction does not occur legally, it is not included in GDP. In conclusion, GDP is a good measure for the most part. It is the single best statistic we have, but it is important to keep in mind what it includes and what it leaves out. This is the end of the Chapter 22 lecture. Be sure to review the math work covered in this chapter. You will see it again on your chapter quiz and on exam 2. Let me know if you have any questions.